My name is Annette Rigaud and I'm an artist working in clay and also using different volcanic rocks and unprocessed materials. So I guess my passion is material to start with. So I'm using ceramic techniques to build three-dimensional forms and ceramic processes to finish them. I usually use found rocks. They're usually found in the nature, bring them from different travels, but also recycle quite a lot. It's quite amazing what we can find in London. The pieces are quite often happening between the rocks I find and the clay I'm using. So I'm quite interested in a collision of the two materials, of the malleable and the natural. And also, well, I'm interested how the material interacts between themselves as well as me forming them. So that's how the work happens usually. So it's in a way like a conversation between materials. I'm trying to add to this conversation. So first of all, I start with just breaking the stones up and incorporating them into mass of clay. I then build the form up using quite simple techniques of coiling mainly and hand forming, sometimes preparing slabs in a quite simple way. It's always quite important to me that the surface looks almost like it hasn't been touched in some places, so there is a very strong feeling of something being quite rough and natural, almost unfired like. And then pieces dry themselves, and there is quite a lot of different forces between the rocks and the clay which are creating different textures. So that's quite magical in a way, that the material just does what it does. And that's quite important to me. It's almost like just letting material perform in a way. So then after the piece is completely dried, it usually goes through several firings until it works for me. So quite often I use different pieces which have been fired and incorporate them into the form. Then often apply different slips, which are quite often colorful. So it's quite a long process in a way, because sometimes I just don't remember how many times I fired something. And it's not important. What's important is the end, if there is an end.